Hello everyone and welcome to the day 6 of Mental Maths Level 1 program. Today we will learn plus 2 formula and we will learn and practice how to apply plus 2 formula on fingers and on abacus as well. So let's start. If we are doing calculations on fingers or on abacus and we want to add 2 but we don't have enough fingers or we don't have enough beads available on abacus to add 2 directly, then what we will do? We will take help from its friend and apply the formula. If we cannot add 2 directly, then to add 2 indirectly, first we will add 5 and subtract its friend. The friend of 2 is 3. The formula would be plus 2 is equals to plus 5 minus 3. Here, plus 2 is problem because we cannot add 2 directly. Plus 5 is our house, base or boss. Minus 3 is friend of plus 2. As when we add 2 and 3 together, they make 5. Let's learn how we can apply plus 2 formula on units. Let's take an example. If we want to add 4 and 2 together, first we will place 4 on abacus. We all know how to place 4 on abacus. We will move 4 lower beads up on unit rod to touch the calculation bar. Now to add 2. As you can see, we do not have any bead on unit rod. We only have upper bead. Upper bead on unit rod has a value 5. So we cannot directly use upper bead. Now to add 2 indirectly, we will apply the formula. First we will add 5, then subtract 3, means we will move upper bead downward and we will move 3 lower beads away from the calculation bar on unit rod. As a result, we get upper bead and 1 lower bead touching the calculation bar, which represents the value 6. So our answer would be 6. Let's take this example on our fingers. If we want to add 4 and 2 on our hands, that is right hand. First we will place 4. We will open 4 fingers on right hand. Now you can see we don't have any finger left to add 2 directly. We only have thumb, which has the value 5. So we cannot add 2 directly. We will take help from the formula. And the formula is, if we want to add 2 indirectly, first we have to add 5 and subtract 3. So we will open thumb on right hand and close 3 fingers from right hand. As a result, we get thumb and 1 finger on right hand, which represents the value 6. This is how we apply plus 2 on abacus and on our fingers. Let us learn how to apply plus 2 formula on tense rod while using abacus. The basic formula would remain same, that is plus 2 is equals to plus 5 minus 3. Now as we are doing on tense rod, so we will change the formula accordingly. Now the formula would be, to add 20, indirectly we add 50 and minus 30. Plus 20 is equals to plus 50 minus 30. Let's take an example. If we want to add 30 and 20 together, how we will do that? First we will place 30. We all know how to place 30 on abacus. We will move 3 lower beads up on tense rod to touch the calculation bar. Now as you can see, we don't have enough beads on tense rod. So we will take help from the formula. Now to add 20 indirectly, first we will add 50 on tense rod, then subtract 30. We will move 3 lower beads away from the calculation bar. As a result, we get upper bead touching the calculation bar and it represents the value 50. So our answer would be 50. Let's take this example of addition of 30 and 20 together on our fingers. As we are doing tens, so we will place values on our left hand. First, we will place 30. To place 30, we will open 3 fingers on left hand. Now, as you can see, we don't have enough fingers to add 20 directly. Either we have one finger which has a value 10, or we have thumb which has the value 50. So we cannot add 20 directly. To add 20 indirectly, we will apply the formula. We will add 50, that is, we will open thumb, and now we will subtract 30, means we will close 3 fingers on left hand. As a result, we get thumb, which represents the value 50. So our answer is 50. Let's take an example for application of plus 2 formulas for different values. How we will apply on different values? Let's see. If we want to add 41 and 26 together, first we will place 41 on abacus. Now to add 26. As you can see, we don't have any lower bit on 10 slot. We have upper bit which has the value 50. So we cannot directly add 20 of 26. We will take help from the formula, and the formula is plus 20 is equals to plus 50 minus 30. Now we will add 50 on 10th rod and subtract 3, means we will move 3 lower bits away from the calculation bar, and we can directly add 6 on units rod, as we have enough bits on units rod to add 6 directly. As a result, we get upper bit and one lower bit touching the calculation bar on 10th rod, and upper bit and two lower bits touching the calculation bar on units rod. So our answer would be 67. Let's take this example on our hands. If we want to add 41 and 26 together on our hands, first we will place 41, that is 4 fingers on left hand and 1 finger on right hand. Now to add 26, we don't have enough finger on left hand to add 20 directly. We will apply the formula. We will open thumb, that is, we will add 50 and subtract 30, means we will close 3 fingers on left hand. Now to add 6 of 26, we can directly add 6 on right hand, as we have enough fingers available to add 6 directly. As a result, we get thumb and one finger on left hand and thumb and two fingers on right hand. This represents the value 67. So our answer is 67. Let us practice application of plus 2 formula on units. First, we will practice on our fingers. Ready, make 0 and let's start. First question is 6 plus 2, we will directly add 2. Minus 5, we will close our thumb. Plus 2, we will apply the formula, as we don't have enough fingers to add 2 directly. We will open our thumb and close 3 fingers. Plus 4, answer 9. Next question, 8 plus 1 minus 5 plus 2 plus 1, answer 7. 0. Next question, 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 1 plus 2, answer 9. 0. Next question is of tens, so we will be doing on our left hand. Ready, make punch on your left hand and let's start. 10 plus 30 plus 20 plus 30 minus 70, answer 20. Next question, 70 plus 10 minus 50 plus 20 plus 40, answer 90. Let's practice application of plus 2 formula on different values. First, we will practice on fingers. Ready? 36. We will directly place 36 on our hands. Plus 21. To add 21, we will apply plus 2 formula on 10's hand and can directly add 1. Plus 42. minus 56 plus 25. We will apply plus 2 formula on left hand and will directly add 5 on units. Answer 68. Next question, make 0. 72 plus 21 minus 51 plus 26 minus 12. Answer 56. 0, 35 plus 24 plus 30 minus 76 plus 82. Answer 95. Last two questions, make 0. 97 minus 67 plus 28 plus 31 minus 57. Answer is 32. Last question, 28 plus 61 minus 56 plus 21 plus 32. Answer 86. Let's practice same set of questions on abacus as well. Let's start. First question is, make your abacus 0, 6. First we will place 6 on units rod, plus 2, we can directly add 2, minus 5, we will move upper bead up away from the calculation bar on units rod, plus 2, we cannot directly add 2 on units. So we will apply the formula, plus 5 minus 3 plus 4. Answer 9. Next question, make your abacus 0, 8 plus 1 minus 5 plus 2 plus 1. Answer 7. Next question, 2 plus 2 plus 2 again, plus 1, plus 2. Answer 9. 0. Next question. Next question is of tens. So we will apply on tens rod. Ready? 10 plus 30 plus 20 plus 30 minus 70. Answer 20. Next question, 70 plus 10 minus 50 plus 20 plus 40. Answer is 90. Let's practice application of plus 2 formula on different values by using abacus. Let's start. Make your abacus 0, 36 plus 21. We will apply plus 2 formula on tens rod only, plus 42 minus 56 plus 25. We will apply plus 2 formula on tens rod only and can directly add 5 on units. Answer 68. Next question, make your abacus 0, 72 plus 21 minus 51 plus 26 minus 12. Answer 56. Next question, 35 plus 24 plus 30 minus 76 plus 82. Answer 95. 0, 97 minus 67 plus 28 plus 31 minus 57. Answer 32. Last question, 28 plus 61 minus 56 plus 21 plus 32. Answer 86. In this video, we have learned plus 2 formula. We have also learned and practiced how to apply plus 2 formula on fingers and on abacus as well. Hopefully, the topic of plus 2 formula is clear to everyone.